Be informed. SMS your name to 046-000 UMA.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين. والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا وحبيبنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. All praise be to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and peace be upon his beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Brothers and sisters, I do say once again, may Allah Azza wa Jalla bless this month to you and your family and the entire ummah. And may Allah Azza wa Jalla make this month a month of victory and an honor and respect to the Muslims all around the world. I could recall that moment that I stood here last year speaking about Ramadan 2012. And subhanallah, time went so quick that now we're in Ramadan 2013, and it's only a matter of time where 2014 will enter, and as quick as time goes, is as quick as our life continues to end. And alhamdulillah, the month of Ramadan comes once a year for us to stop and pause and reflect upon the past 11 months. What have we done? And the next upcoming 11 months, what are we planning to do? This is the aim of the month of Ramadan. And this is the aim of every single Muslim and believer they should be aiming for. Unfortunately, you see, a lot of the Muslims take the month of Ramadan as a month of food and sweets and hanging out and watching TV and new episodes and so on. They've got it really wrong. But the month of Ramadan is that moment that you stop and pause. Reflect upon the actions that you've done in the past 11 months and the actions that you are planning to do in the next 11 months. Where have you been in the past 11 months? And where are you planning to be in the next 11 months? And ikhwani, wallahi, it's so sad that a lot of us enter the month of Ramadan and come out of the month of Ramadan the way they entered it. Because the month of Ramadan is about where you're going to be after the month of Ramadan. What's your condition going to be after the month of Ramadan? What's your situation going to be with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala after the month of Ramadan? And I know every single one of us right now, because of the beginning of the month of Ramadan and at the beginning of the month of Ramadan, where we are at the beginning of the month of Ramadan, is planning a lot of good. There's a lot of good in our minds and good intentions. Every single one of us is planning a lot of good, and you could see that from the sign of the number of people that attend the center and the number of people that attend the mosque. But why is it halfway through the month of Ramadan you find the mosques and the centers are half empty now? What's going on here? It looks like a lot of the things that we planned and a lot of the things that we aim to achieve, we're not even achieving them. It looks like a lot of the things that we want to gain, we're not even gaining them. And that's what's been happening every single year. Every single year we enter the month of Ramadan with good hearts, sincere hearts, good, clear, pure minds, planning. Planning so much to do in the month of Ramadan, but yet we don't even gain anything of what we planned. And we come out of the month of Ramadan the way we entered it. Take advantage of this month. Take advantage of what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives in this month. It is a month that the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam calls, and he says it's a gift of Allah upon you. That if the people and the Muslims knew what Allah gives in this month to his servants, what Allah grants the believers in this month, what Allah grants his servants in this month, from his mercy, from his forgiveness, from his grace, from his blessings, wallahi, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, every single one of us would have wished and hoped that our entire life is Ramadan. Not once a year, but every single day of our lives. If we knew what Allah gives, if we knew what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives us in this month, the mercy that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala descends down, and the forgiveness that Allah azza wa jal forgives, and how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala looks at you, and Allah looks at someone, Allah will never punish him. If we knew what Allah grants his servants in this month, we would have wished that our entire life is Ramadan. We would have said, Ya Rab, make every single day of my life Ramadan. Make every single week and every month of my life is Ramadan. But we don't know. But the Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam tells us. And he says, alayhi salatu wassalam, about this month, awwaluhu rahmah, wa awsatuhu maghfirah, wa akhiruhu itqun min an-nar. The beginning of this month is rahmah, mercy from Allah. Halfway through this month is forgiveness from Allah. The last part and portion of this month is saving from the hellfire. The beginning of this month, rahmah, mercy from Allah. And how much are we in need of the rahmah of Allah? Because of the mercy of Allah we live. Because of the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala we walk. Because of the mercy of Allah azza wa jalla we speak. Because of the mercy of Allah we eat and we drink. It's all the mercy of Allah. It's because of the mercy of Allah, Allah keeps us alive. It's because of the mercy of Allah, Allah allows us to pray to Him. It's because of the mercy of Allah, Allah gathers us in this beautiful gathering. This is the beginning of the month of Ramadan, mercy. Then, it is forgiveness. Halfway through the month of Ramadan is forgiveness. Forgiveness of what? Of the sins that we have been committed and we committed in the last 11 months. So many sins that we've carried in and entered this month with. So many sins that we had committed in the last 11 months. So many evil deeds that we have done. So many evil deeds that we had perpetrated. So many evil deeds that we had committed. And now Allah says to you, you know what? Those 11 months and the sins that you had committed in, enter the month of Ramadan and I'll forgive you. Allahu Akbar. What a Lord! What a Lord! That you disobey Him for 11 months, then the month of Ramadan comes, you worship Allah and say, Ya Allah, forgive me. And Allah says to you, I forgive you. All the sins that you had committed in the last 11 months are all forgotten. All forgiven. All wiped away. All erased. Is that a Lord? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Does Allah azza wa jalla deserve to be neglected? Does Allah azza wa jalla deserve to be forgotten? Does Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala deserve to be delayed? The way we delay Him when it comes to the salah, later. When it comes to reading the Quran, later. When it comes to doing something good, later. And Allah azza wa jalla does not delay that moment to forgive you. Allah does not delay that moment to have mercy upon you. Allah does not delay that moment that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sustains you. Have you ever waited for your food? Waited hours or days for your food to come, or water to come, or clothing to come? Allah never delayed anything upon you. So why do you delay your repentance to Allah? Why? This is the month of repentance. Seek Allah's forgiveness. That, Ya Allah, I have disobeyed you for the last 11 months, and I want to enter this month with so much dirt on my back that I want to be cleaned. I want it to be all cleaned, purified. Halfway through this month is forgiveness. And this is what you need to aim for. That Allah forgives you in this month. That Allah Azza wa Jal wipes away all those evil deeds and sins that we have been committing for the last 11 months. In Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, he says, may their nose be rubbed on the ground, that those who live and experience the month of Ramadan, and yet their sins are not even forgiven. And Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam is amazed. He is shocked. He is surprised from such a person that will live the month of Ramadan, experience the month of Ramadan, and yet their sins are not forgiven. What type of person is he? What type of a person are you? That you live the month of Ramadan and you come out of the month of Ramadan and your sins are not forgiven? What are you? What kind of a dirt is that on you? What kind of a dirt is that on you that you stand under the shower for hours and you still come out stinking? Doesn't make sense. And yet did it make sense to the Prophet ﷺ that one of us will live the month of Ramadan and come out of the month of Ramadan and yet their sins are not forgiven? Halfway through this month is forgiveness, my brothers and sisters in Islam. And no doubt, no matter how good and perfect we think we are, we still have sins. And that sins needs to be cleaned away. That sins need to be forgiven. And no one will forgive your sins except Allah Azza wa Jal. That's one thing you only get from Allah. Because if this entire world gets together to forgive you, no one can. Unless Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wills. You need Allah's forgiveness. You need Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive you. And the month of Ramadan is the month of mercy and the month of forgiveness. The month of mercy and the month of forgiveness. And we are all in need of the mercy of Allah and the forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Month of repentance. We all need to begin this month with repentance. That Ya Rab, Ya Allah, You are my Lord that you created me. You are my Lord that sustains me. You are my Lord that gives me. You are my Lord that forgives me. Ya Rab, I have disobeyed you for the last 11 months. Shame on me that I have disobeyed you for the last 11 months. And here I am on my knees seeking your forgiveness because I know no one will forgive me except you. This is what you need to do. Begin the month of Ramadan with repentance. With purification. From what? From the sins that we had committed. From the evil deeds that we had fallen into. From the shortcomings that we have towards our Lord, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Yes, shortcomings. Shortcomings. Shortcomings in our worship. Shortcomings in our responsibilities. Shortcomings in our duties. We need to seek Allah's forgiveness for these shortcomings. Because there's a lot of things that we should be doing for our Lord, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, for Islam, for our religion, and yet we don't even do it. So we need to ask Allah for forgiveness. Ya Allah, forgive me for my shortcomings. Allah never has shortcomings towards you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala never has shortcomings towards you. He gives you food, He gives you water, He gives you shelter, He gives you clothing, He gives you children, He gives you wealth, He gives you air, and He continues to give you and give you and give you and give you. He never has shortcomings towards you. So why do you have shortcomings towards Him? Why? Why do you have shortcomings towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Seek Allah's forgiveness over your shortcomings. Your shortcomings towards your Lord. Your shortcomings towards Islam. Your shortcomings towards your religion. This is why we need to ask Allah Azza wa Jalla in this month. A month of mercy, a month of forgiveness. And then the end of this month is saving from the hellfire. Allah saves you from the hellfire. Because if Allah has mercy upon someone and Allah forgives him, then Allah Azza wa Jalla will save him from the hellfire. Aim. Aim that you want to be from amongst those that Allah Azza wa Jalla will record on his list. That those will never ever enter the hellfire. This is what you should be aiming for. فَمَنْ زُحْزِحَ عَنِ النَّارِ وَأُدْخِلَ الْجَنَّةَ فَقَدْ فَازْ. Whoever is removed away from the hellfire, then enters the paradise, is indeed had succeeded the great success. Aim that this should be your success. To be from amongst those that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will have mercy upon, Allah will forgive, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make those that will never ever 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 taste or enter the hellfire. This is the month of Ramadan. Can you understand that? Has it sunk in your mind? This is the month of Ramadan. A beautiful month. A beautiful month that brings a lot of gifts. A guest that carries so many gifts that you can't get from anywhere else. And this guest is only going to be staying with you for 30 days and then go again. Fayakhwani, let's take the most out of this month. Utilize that month. Aim that, Ya Allah, I want to be from those that you have mercy upon. And those that you forgive. And those that you never ever let into the hellfire. This is what every single one of us should be aiming for now. And work for it hard. Then fall during halfway through the month of Ramadan as you see a lot of Muslims. Then take a step backwards as you see a lot of people do. Be firm, be strong, be steadfast. Aim that this month is the best month of Ramadan that you've ever experienced in your life. This month is going to be the best Ramadan that you ever lived in your life. The best Ramadan that you've ever experienced in your life. And if you want Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's support, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will support you. For that, my brothers and sisters in Islam, let us inshallah get our motivation and enthusiasm high. Let us move forward inshallah and take the most out of this month. Let it be the best month that you've ever ever experienced in your life. And I ask Allah Azza wa Jal to make us from amongst those who Allah Azza wa Jal have mercy upon, and Allah will forgive. and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make from amongst those that will never ever enter the hellfire. As I mentioned to you, my brothers, every day we'll be starting at 7 p.m. Salat al-Isha, then the Tarawih prayers. Halfway through the Tarawih prayers, there will be different speakers and lecturers from imams and da'is in English for 10 to 15 minutes maximum. Then the rest of the Tarawih prayers, then the Witr prayers. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept from you all. Jazakumullah khair.